Let me ask you this. What is the largest PDF you've ever seen? Well, I've got a fun little but pointless video for you today, and how I started down this rabbit hole was a bit random, but basically, several days ago, I was creating a custom GPT. So you know ChatGPT, there's the plus feature that you can pay for, and then you can create these custom GPTs where it's basically ChatGPT, but it can reference different documents you upload. I wanted to create one for Windows troubleshooting. So I found out that Microsoft on their documentations pages lets you basically download all their documentation, different sections of it as a PDF, which is great because then I can simply upload that to the GPT and it can reference it, and then it might be better at troubleshooting than regular ChatGPT. Anyway, I found it kind of funny because when you go to download the PDF, in this case, I went to the top level of the Windows troubleshooting pages and literally just clicked download on all of it, so it put everything into a giant 2,000 page PDF, which I already thought at the beginning was a huge PDF, but little did I know, those are rookie numbers. Now, someone actually responded to one of my tweets mentioning a 78,000 page PDF from Microsoft you can download. We'll get to that. I want to still build some suspense, but actually, despite what the title of this video may say, it's not actually the largest PDF I found. We'll get to one that is even bigger, more than twice as large. Anyway, just out of boredom or curiosity, whatever you want to call it, I went around searching the web for the absolute largest PDFs I could find in terms of pages. Though I did set one restriction on myself, which is I wanted to find the longest, like, real PDF that was actually used by something in public, not just someone who went and created a long PDF just for the sake of it, because I'm sure those are out there. I wanted to find an actual one. Anyway, here's some of the ones I found. First of all, you know ARM, that CPU architecture? Well, turns out they have some really long documents, and one of them was ARM Architecture Reference Manual for A Profile Architecture. And this one was 12,000 pages at 73 megabytes. This one is way too technical for me to even try to explain what it is, but I guess if something is gonna be a large document, it's gonna be a technical reference of some kind. Another large one I found was 20,000 pages, also from Microsoft. It's the SQL Server 2000 Retired Technical Documentation, and it was 20,000 pages at 92 megabytes. And actually, this is gonna be a recurring theme, this retired documentation thing. Apparently, Microsoft used to just put all the documentation for certain software in one massive PDF. These days, more recently, if you look up more recent versions of the documentation for newer versions, they seem to have split it up. So the really long documents only go back so far, but there are quite a few that I found of those. Another one of those is the Visual Studio 2005 retired documentation, and this one actually also was split up, but even still, there were some massive PDFs. So the general instructions English version was 34,000 pages at 156 megabytes, and the SDK documentation was 46,000 pages at 233 megabytes. And that was all just a bunch of documentation regarding the software Visual Studio. It's an IDE, and apparently it's a very complicated program even way back in 2005, so yeah, pretty big file. But now we can get to that one massive file, the 78,000 page PDF, which was for BizTalk Server 2009 retired technical documentation. And for those 78,000 pages, it takes up 420 megabytes. I tried to look up what BizTalk Server was. The basic interpretation I got was that it basically allows enterprises to kind of connect together different types of software. So I guess the name is it lets different software talk to each other, something like that. Now, one funny thing was I looked at the other languages versions of this document thinking, well, maybe in some languages it's longer, but it turns out that all these different language versions are actually the same exact length. But not only that, the documents are actually entirely the same. Literally the only difference is that like the first couple pages are in the different language. So I don't understand the point of having different language downloads. They're literally the same. And if you're curious about whether the documentation got longer in later versions, I looked at the BizTalk Server 2010 documentation, but it looks like starting there, they actually started splitting up the documents. So in that case, the largest file was only 11,000 pages. So now you might be wondering, what could possibly be a larger PDF than this 78,000 page behemoth? And I actually came across a PDF that is a whopping 200,000 pages. But before I get to that, I do have some honorable mentions that are kind of interesting. First of all is a novelty PDF that I found that is 2 million pages long. I didn't really include this in the true list because the pages are all empty. Apparently, this thing works by having 10 PDF objects, and then 7 are page groups that recursively contain 8 copies of the next page group for a total of 8 to the 7th, or exactly 2,097,152 pages. And also, while I was searching for massive PDFs, I did find people on various forums and places mentioning the existence of even more massive PDFs, although they don't seem to have been public or anywhere I could find them, but I thought I'd still mention them. There's one news outlet or organization called CT Mirror, it's Connecticut Mirror, and apparently they paid the Connecticut government $200 for a full list of unclaimed property, and the government apparently gave it to them in a 300,000 page PDF. That's government efficiency for you. There was also a Stack Overflow page where someone mentions trying to deal with a 400,000 page PDF and asking for advice on that. And believe it or not, I found several references of people talking about million page PDFs, I kid you not. So there was one Reddit post where someone mentioned it in a comment, having to deal with a million page PDF. There was another article I read about someone who was trying to compile disease statistics or something like that, and they apparently had to sift through PDFs that were hundreds of thousands of pages long, up to a million. I tried to look for these too, but I could not find them, unfortunately, because that definitely would have been the record breaker. And there was also a random forum post I saw where someone mentioned having a 600,000 PDF and also having million page PDFs. So I don't know what these are for. I would be curious about that, but I imagine it's just like some business that uses PDF when they probably should not, for whatever purpose that is. So now the moment we've all been waiting for, the largest PDF that I could find at a whopping 200,000 pages. Well, just about. And this one's actually going to surprise you. It's pretty cool. It's actually a PDF game. That's right. It's a game called Undying Dusk, and it's like a dungeon crawler that takes the form of a PDF file. Impressively, the file is only 188 megabytes. Not sure how they managed that, but how this thing works is basically you have to open it up in a PDF reader, first of all, that can support it. And one example is Sumatra Reader. It's the one I actually use. It's a really lightweight, open source PDF reader. And I did try to open it in Acrobat, Adobe Acrobat, against the recommendation of the game creator. And of course, Adobe Acrobat totally choked on this, but Sumatra PDF had no issues opening it. And how you play the game is you simply click on text links that are on each PDF page. I did actually start playing it for a very short time, and it's actually surprisingly complex. I have to imagine they made this programmatically somehow, maybe not. But it even has stuff like controls where there's arrows that you click on for which direction you want the character to go. And every button you press goes to a unique PDF page that is specific to that location in the physical game world, with the character facing that direction. And I believe at any given location, you can also press the info button to show your character. So that's at least double the amount of pages just to be able to do that. Another cool thing is when you go to different areas, you can click a link that will open your browser and play some music if you want to have that in the background. But yeah, it's basically like an RPG dungeon crawler that you play with a PDF reader. It's very cool. Of course, I'll put the link in the description if you want to check that out. Of course, now that I made this video, I'm sure some of you out there know of even larger PDFs that you can find somewhere. Though, just keep in mind, I have YouTube not set to allow links in the comment section, so it's better if you just describe where to get it. Anyway, if you found this video kind of fun, then be sure to give this video a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. It really helped out, and this is a bit of a different video, more purely fun, so also let me know down in the comments if you like this kind of thing. Or maybe even have some other random purely fun video ideas I could consider in the future. Now, if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about some common computer mistakes that people make, and this one actually is a useful video. I'll put that link right there you can click on. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.